In this video, I want to show you, is it worth it to shoot in HDR in 2025? And I also want to talk to you about the standard dynamic range space versus the high dynamic range space. So let's start by that, and then we're going to retouch an HDR at the end, one of my best HDR this year. But this is a panorama. This is a crazy panorama I did with an ND10. Look at the behind the scene. Guys, I'm using this rock as a foreground element with an ND10 to get this rocks here early morning in Antibes, and French Riviera. It's insane. Okay, so we're back, and what I did is I took actually two photos. So each photo was 30-second exposure. Look at that, 30-second. Kind of crazy, 30-second. And I took two photos. Why did I take two photos? Because I really wanted to get the sun there. And this is when the HDR space is going to come handy. So I'm going to select both photos. I'm going to right-click, and I'm going to do a photo merge panorama, okay? And then on this one, I'm going to take perspective. Why? Because often, if I use cylindrical or spherical, I get like an horizon which is a bit curvy, and I don't like this. Perspective, it gives me a very straight horizon. So I've already done it, and here's the final result. Now on this one, I'm gonna use my sunset preset, which you can download right under this video. Boom, look at this, one click. And look at this, look how incredible this photo is. One of my favorite photos this year. And then I'm gonna go here, and I'm gonna make it as a 69 by pano. So remember the rule of third, let's go for 1/3 of, you know, sky, 2/3 of water, I like that. Let's make it straight, let's follow the horizon. Boom, there you go. Look at that. And when you use my preset, you're gonna do three things. You're gonna hold on the Option key, check your black point. In this case, it's actually perfect. So, you know, the black point, when you hold on the Alt key, if you go left, what you see in red and magenta and red and dark is going 100% black. And you wanna get a bit of that, like maybe 1 or 2%. And then you do your whites. Yeah, I wanna make it kind of brighter. And voila, and then you do your white balance. I actually love the white balance in this case. I don't want to change anything. The white balance is absolutely perfect. Let's clean up a little bit the photo. I see there's some sensor dust here and here and here. But check this out. Here, the sky is fully burned. And here it's fully burned. Now, normally I don't use this option when the sun is present, but in this one it kind of worked. Check this out, are you ready? I'm gonna go to the HDR space. And look at this. Look at how much details I'm getting back in the sky. Look again, before, look at the top of the sky, after. Now, what I don't like is this. I don't like that the sun is all burned like this, so I'm gonna back down the highlights to make it glow a little bit more. I still don't like it very much, but I like it better than this, because this really shows that it lacks of information, and now we have a lot more information. And then to finish off this beautiful photo, I'm gonna go in here, I'm gonna take a brush, make sure the brush flow intensity is a bit in the 80s, a bit of exposure, and I'm gonna brush a little bit of brightness here to, you know, to show the 30-second exposure. Maybe not that much, but just a little bit. Look at this, before the brush, after. It's just to show the mist. Sometimes what I do is I do twice. I do two brush, and I don't do it everywhere, just to show the mist even more. And mist is supposed to be irregular. Look at that. Look at this photo. It's kind of cool. Now, let's talk about whether it's worth shooting in HDR or not. So this is an HDR. I showed this in another video recently. Look at this. Normal exposure, underexposed, overexposed. I'm going to take all three. I'm going to right click, and I'm going to go to Photo Merge HDR. And I'm just going to HDR it. So it's going to blend them into one thing. The whole idea is I'm supposed to get more data in the highlights and the shadows, okay? And you do it usually when you have a situation like this. Okay, now I have an HDR file. On this one, I'm gonna apply my sunset preset again. And boom. Make sure when you apply my preset, you hold down the Option key. So you do your black point, white point. Maybe let's tweak a little bit the white balance. Yeah, something like that. Maybe add a bit more contrast. And then I'm gonna crop it 16:9. There's a lot of dust on top, which I'm gonna get rid of like this. Then maybe boost a little bit the highlights to make the sky glow a little bit more. And then I'm gonna go here and erase that dust here and dust there. Okay, good. I wanna make the top of the sky a bit darker. So let's go into the preset. The preset has like some local adjustment. Let's go to sky. Let's maybe lower this a little bit more or increase even more. It's darkness. Darkness, my good friend. And then bottom, sorry, I lost my voice a little bit here. but it's okay. And check this out. Look at this. I love this result. So once you got the result that you like, I'm going to Command-Shift-C. I'm going to take all of that, and I'm going to copy it onto the normal exposure. And now we're going to press C, Shift-Tab, and we're going to compare the result of the HDR versus the normal exposure. And you will see there's absolutely no difference. And 99% of the time I do an HDR, I do that, and I don't see any difference. Look, the highlights are the same. The shadow is the same. It doesn't have less noise in the HDR. I don't know if it's because I use my Sony 7R5, which is an amazing sensor, but it's crazy. However, look at the highlights. If I now go to the HDR space, are you ready? 1, 2, 3. Boom. Look at that. We get a lot more details in the highlights. And I can do it on the HDR, and I can do it on the single exposure. Look at this. Same result. Exactly same result. Boom. I get a lot more details. Now, let's see another example. A true HDR. Underexpose, normal expose, overexpose. I'm going to select all three, right-click, edit, photo merge, HDR. Let's put my theory to the test. So I'm going to merge it. And what I want to do is I'm going to retouch the HDR version using my preset. So here is the HDR that has a 3 exposure. I'm going to use my sunset preset on it. One click. Amazing. Check my black point. Remember to download my preset under my white point. A bit lower the highlights. Maybe make it brighter. It reminds me of a photo that I sold to a Nike years ago. Made some good money on that view. Okay, and then I'm going to go 16:9. It's funny, you know, I know a lot of people don't like presets, but I love presets. I use them on every single photo. It's like I couldn't live without my presets. Now, why am I giving them to you? I am giving them to you because I'm hoping that one day you allow me to coach you. I'd love to see your photos. You know, you have all the information down below. Do also my challenge. There's a new challenge I just did, which I'm going to teach you 80% of retouching in basically 80 minutes. It's a 6-day challenge, but it's very short. You're going to love it. It's under this video. Okay, anyway, it's the best training I've ever done, I think. And it's totally free. Totally free. Okay, so here we are. Okay, I love this. Okay, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy all of that we did. So it's basically the preset. And then I'm going to take the normal exposure, which is this one. And I'm going to copy this. And then we're going to compare both photos like we did earlier to see if there is a plus of having the HDR. Okay? So let's zoom in. So on the right side, you got the HDR with a 3 exposure. Let's look in the highlights here, especially on the left side. I don't see any difference. Let's look in the shadow. If we have less noise in HDR, I don't see a difference. I really don't. I do not see a difference at all. I mean, both photos are amazing. Now, the reason I took this one is, check this out. Now, if I use the HDR space on this one, look at this. It's not going to work because sometimes when the sun is too big, you get that issue. And no matter what you do with the highlights, you can't get it back. So unfortunately, on this one, I cannot use the HDR option. But voila. So my answer to should you do HDR, look, if you don't know what you're doing in terms of exposure, you better bracket so you have it. But you can test this. Do the HDR, apply one of my presets, then copy that to, you know, to one of your exposure, you know, change it and see what's better for you. The HDR or the normal exposure. 99% of the case, for me, the single exposure is enough, and I don't bracket that much. I only bracket when the sun is in my shot. If I don't have the sun, I do not bracket. So that's my viewpoint on HDR in 2025. Did you see this video I did comparing Lightroom Classic with Lightroom CC? It's a really cool video. Check it out. It's starting now, but get my preset first.